About a year ago, I decided to switch to Engram, an alternative keyboard layout to QWERTY. And now I'm gonna explain you why I kind of regret it. So let's start from the beginning. Why did I choose to try an alternative layout to QWERTY? The main reason is that I kind of had finished my ergonomic journey. I started with the Dygma Race, which is a split stagger keyboard, and then moved to the Defy, which is a columnar split ergonomic keyboard. So I kind of ticked all the boxes. So, inspired by a video that we did about a year ago about all the different alternative layouts to QWERTY, I decided it was time to try a new one. But why did I choose Engram? Why not other more popular ones such as the Borac or Colemak? Well, the reason I chose Engram is a bit weird. It's because I wanted to try this keyboard, which is the Linksware Cat. And as you can see, it's missing this inner column because it has this scroll wheel. So I needed to choose a layout that didn't have keys on the inner column. And that layout was Engram, a layout that doesn't have keys on the inner columns. It only has symbols, which I was able to remap to other layers if I wanted. Let me know if you want me to talk about the experience I had with this keyboard in another video. One of the main benefits of Engram is that it reduces finger movement. All the alpha keys are under your pinky, ring, middle, or index finger. And only the symbols are in the inner columns. It's true that there is a couple of keys in the outer column for the pinky, but that's for Q and C, which are not used too much in English. The other benefit is within its name, Engram. It's because the most common bigrams and trigrams in English are paired together. So for example, if you wanna type U, they'll here. You just have to roll your fingers, Y-O-U. Or if you wanna type any word that has H-T or T-H, which is very common in English, those two keys are under your index and middle finger on the right hand. Of course, Engram is far from perfect. It has a few drawbacks, but we'll talk about those later. Now let's talk about my journey learning this new layout, because learning a new layout is not a walk in the park. I started this journey about 8 or 9 months ago, in April 2024. And now, about 9 months later, in January 2025, I'm not even back to the speed that I had on QWERTY. Keep in mind that I was already a touch typist in QWERTY, and I was used to typing on a columnar keyboard. I'm not completely sure if that has helped me or hurt me, but I think it was important for you to know. During the first few weeks, I started very slow. I set up the layout on my keyboard, I printed the layout and put it on the screen, and did a few typing sessions of 30 minutes or 1 hour a day with something like Monkey Type. I did that for a few weeks and got my words per minute from 10 words per minute at the beginning to 25 words per minute. When I reached that speed, which is painstakingly slow, I decided to go all in and started typing only on Engram. I can tell you, my boss didn't like that at all, but it helped me increase my speed a lot. By the end of May, I had gone from 25 words per minute to almost 50 words per minute. That was great. I was very happy, but then I hit a wall. During the next weeks, it was really frustrating to try to ramp up my speed. The moment I started typing faster, it was like my brain switched to QWERTY. And in the middle of a sentence, I started typing completely different words. And my boss was not happy again. Fortunately, this didn't last too long. After the summer holidays, it was like something clicked on my brain. And I started improving my speed once more. However, this time my progression was slower, and I have only reached about 70 words per minute in a good day and 60 in a bad day. Let me do a typing test now so you can see my speed and also notice how my fingers move, or should I say, don't move so much on the keyboard. Okay, so as you can see, my fingers don't move a lot while typing, especially on a typing test where there are no punctuation marks. This is good for ergonomics, but as I said before, not everything about Engram is great. As you can see, I'm not as fast with Engram as I was with QWERTY, where I could reach about 80 or even 90 words per minute in some tests. Also, Engram can only be optimized to be used with one language, in this case, English, because the bigrams and trigrams in other languages are completely different. For example, I also type in Spanish. Remember, I'm Spanish. Oy. And when I type in Spanish, the flow of the hands is not so nice as when I type in English. Also, remember that the Q and the Z are pressed with the pinky, and in Spanish, these letters are much more used than in English. For example, the word que, that it translates to what or which in English, is used a lot.
¿Qué?
You also need the ñ, which I placed here, so you have to kind of reach a little bit with your pinky all the time. That's something that you don't really want to do too much. To top that off, here in Dygma we use the Z a lot because our configurator software is called Basecore with a Z. That won't affect most of the people, but in my particular case, I find myself reaching for the Z a lot during the day. Those are the main flaws that I found about Engram in particular. But there are other drawbacks to switching to an alternative layout that are not specific to Engram, but about all alternative layouts, such as Colemak, Workman, Devorak, or any other alternative layout that you switch to. The first one, of course, is the time it takes to get used to it. But ignoring that, there are other drawbacks. For example, I have lost all ability to type on QWERTY in this layout. I cannot type on QWERTY on a columnar keyboard in any way, shape, or form. I have also lost the ability to touch type on a mechanical keyboard even if it's a staggered layout, like for example the Race 2. My brain still switches to Engram, but if I look at the keyboard, I can kind of type in QWERTY. Let me show you. As you can see, 28 words per minute, terrible. This is not as bad if I have to type my own thoughts because I don't have to be looking at the screen and back at my keyboard, but still not very good. And if you have to look at your keyboard, your neck is gonna suffer. So basically, I try to not type with the Dygma Race 2, only if I need to test it for some firmware testing or anything like that. Surprisingly, it's not that bad with a laptop keyboard. My brain kind of still remembers my old typing technique with the laptop. Let me get into hacker mode. So, as you can see, 60 words per minute, not super fast, a little bit slower than I am with Engram, but completely usable. And if I switch to the laptop for more time, let's say 15 minutes or even 30 minutes, my speed keeps picking up and I reach 70 or 80 words per minute. So, as you can see, it's like my brain kind of retains two different muscle memories. One for mechanical keyboards and one for non-mechanical keyboards. I thought that maybe I could keep a different memory for staggered mechanical keyboards and one for columnar mechanical keyboards. So I could have a muscle memory for the Defy, a muscle memory for my Race 2, and a muscle memory for my laptop. Like how you can save different configurations in different neurons. But so far, I've only been able to keep these two. Maybe if I try to touch type on my Race 2 and I train it with QWERTY, I would be able to bring that speed back. Or maybe the easiest way would be to put Engram on my Race 2. But you can see the drawback here. My muscle memory while typing is not so versatile now. I need my mechanical keyboard to have Engram. Luckily, I can switch to my laptop if I want, but still, there is a constraint. So you have to be very thoughtful about the benefits that you're gonna get with your new layout compared to QWERTY. If I'm gonna grab a colleague's keyboard, it's a mechanical keyboard, it's gonna be in QWERTY and I will have to look at the keys to type. If something were to happen to my keyboard and I had to grab a colleague's keyboard,
please don't die, don't die,
it would be in QWERTY and I would have to look at the keyboard to type. So, do I regret switching to Engram? Well, yes and no. On one hand, typing on Engram is mostly much more comfortable. Even though I'm not up to my previous speed, I can notice that my fingers move far less. But on the other hand, it's not like I had pain on my fingers before. I can type on QWERTY without feeling any pain in my fingers or my hands. So I haven't felt any ergonomic benefit, if you want to put it that way. In my ideal ergonomic journey, I would start with a keyboard that is split, then that is programmable, probably with extra thumb keys. Then I would move to a keyboard that is either tented and then has a columnar layout like the Dygma D5. And only after I tried all that, and if I'm still feeling pain, I would then try an alternative keyboard layout. I don't think that an alternative keyboard layout such as Engram can help you too much if you're still using a non-split keyboard. Getting a split keyboard is a must in the ergonomic journey. So as a wrap up, go through your ergonomic journey and at the end, if you still have pain or maybe you just want to try something new, then I would recommend trying an alternative layout. But as I said, it's a long journey. I'm still in that journey. I'm still not back to my typing speed. It has some benefits. My fingers move far less, but it also has the drawbacks that we have mentioned. So take all that into consideration when deciding to try a new layout. And if you decide that you want to try an alternative keyboard layout, you're masochist. Check out this video here where we talk about the most common alternatives to QWERTY. Bye!